Please get ready for a dictation of exercise number 2 from the legal material. 5 seconds. Start. Duty Constable Vinay Kumar, who was posted at AIIMS, forwarded information to police station Hazrat Nizamuddin, pursuant whereof DD number 27A was recorded and handed over to ASI Jeet Singh for inquiry, who reached AIIMS and obtained MLC of Prosecutrix. However, Prosecutrix was not found in the hospital. Thereafter, he went to the house of Prosecutrix, but the same was found locked. On inquiring, neighbors informed that Prosecutrix with her family members had gone out of Delhi. ASI Jeet Singh again visited house of Prosecutrix, but neither the Prosecutrix nor her family members made any statement before him on the pretext that Prosecutrix was not well. Later, investigations was handed over to SI Saroj Bala, who on 20th October 2006 visited the house of Prosecutrix along with Ms. Garima, who was working with a NGO, Prayatan, and recorded statement of Prosecutrix, wherein she stated that in the evening of 25th September 2006, she had gone to bathroom for urinating, and when she was returning, appellant came there and pulled her inside a room situated behind her house and made her to lay down in a bed. She tried to raise alarm. He gagged her mouth from one hand. In the meanwhile, her mother came there, and on seeing her, appellant got up and ran away. On the basis of this statement of Prosecutrix, FIR was registered at police station Hazrat Nizamuddin. Appellant was arrested and was medically examined. Doctor opined that there was nothing to suggest that appellant was incapable of performing sexual intercourse in normal circumstances. Blood sample of appellant was taken and sealed. Later on, this was deposited in the Malkhana. Vaginal smear in sealed condition with seal of CMO AIIMS, which was earlier handed over to him in the hospital by the doctor, was deposited by him in the Malkhana. Appellant filed a suit for permanent and mandatory injunction against the respondents for restraining them from raising any construction or to attempt to fence with barbed wire or to create any third-party interest in the property bearing number 12/109-C, Geeta Colony, Delhi, claiming herself to be the owner of the same. She also sought mandatory injunction for directing the respondents to remove the door from the wall of premises number 12/109-C, Geeta Colony, Delhi. The said suit was dismissed by the trial court while its judgment and decree dated 28th August 2004. Aggrieved by the said judgment and decree, appellant filed regular appeal before the additional district judge, Delhi. The said appeal also met the same fate and was dismissed by the appellate court while his judgment dated 26th October 2009. Learned counsel for the appellant has submitted that the court erred in holding that appellant had failed to prove that she was the owner of the property in suit, especially when documents showing her ownership were duly marked on the record. She further submitted that trial court also did not take into consideration the site plan filed by the appellant before the court. According to her, trial court went wrong in appreciating the evidence of the parties adduced on record, even when respondent did not file any written statement, and thus respondents admitted the claim of the appellant as made in the plaint. She has argued that in view of Section 58 of the Evidence Act, non-filing of written statement in itself amounts to admission, and since the court failed to appreciate the factum of respondents not filing the written statement, it erred in law by ignoring the provision of Section 58 of the Evidence Act. Section 58 of the Evidence Act speaks of facts admitted need not be proved in evidence. Stop.